All right, time to do some Alone in the Dark. This is Horror Fest 2024. Oh, excuse me. I think just for the record, we're just going to do standard. Now we're going to do modern here because this is my very first time playing a Alone in the Dark, let alone this. Ribbit. Just keep on walking there, Gator. Just keep on walking.
Jeremy didn't kill himself. Is that why he's at your setup?
Despite being convinced that he's truly possessed, he decided to put his last chips on Dr. Gray and his psychoanalysis, figuring he might stumble upon some cure.
You mentioned the letter.
I received a disturbing letter from Jeremy accusing the staff and all the other patients of being involved in some cult. And now they are also out.
Could it be real? Or is it all just in his head?
It's a story he tells himself, Mr. Gray. I need to avoid the truth.
You choose.
That we're all terribly insignificant. That people mean so very little. But there is no one out to get Jeremy off because he isn't with me.
Sure, nothing says unwanted cooperation than a gun waving around. I think we're going to start with Mr. Edward first.
Don't run back.
Chapter 1. Look for a way inside the house. Okay. Got ourselves a little bit of a clue. All right, so we got a kitchen garden key. All right, so that's one clue. So something tells me I might be in for a Resident Evil, like, game here. Pistol bullets. Okay, so which means we're gonna need an item. Housekeeper key, huh? Okay. Let's see if it opens up that door. Nope. Not the key for it. Who would have thought alcohol could restore health? Welcome to Dirketto. So I guess the alcohol is like the herbs in from Resident Evil, so to speak. Make yourself comfortable by putting someone else through suffering. It's been of good use to me. It seems all hard as in my book. I see some words dreamt up by the Creoles, and I carry around a small pocket of greenery. Nothing of this is mentioned in the Bible, of course. A French port of things here. Oh, it's just the doorknob. Go that way yet.
Please do not touch the boiler. It is working after all. While the sabotage has caused a leak, only the decorative plate has been completely ruined. Let's wait for Mr. Chance to turn up and he can take a look at the leak. Mr. Wentz.
Okay, so I guess that's a clue. But we're gonna come back a little later. Rat poison. Interesting. Lagni apes?
Yes, sir. The old plantation.
Oh, I don't have a map. Lagni apes are not essential items that you can find throughout the game. Completing sets will uncover forbidden knowledge and sometimes even more. Okay, so it's like mixing things together, if I understand that right. Some sets can't be completed without playing both Carnby's and Emily's campaign. Ooh. Like it. Over, huh? This just makes things more interesting. All right. Crescent City. So yeah, someone tells me I'm going to be playing this game more than once. Which is fine. So it looks like we're missing some pieces. it's locked. Lottie's diary. Interesting. All right, so we're gonna need yet another key. It looks like we got a map. So yep, it looks like this is Resident Evil for sure. At least that's the impression I get. Piazza key. That's not the right key. Let's go check upstairs. So I need something to pry that out. So we'll come back a little later. Oh, so we're back outside in the garden. Got another locked door. How many keys does this house really need?
Trouble. Just let us see the old man. Satisfy the curiosity of my client. We'll be off. have time for any of this. Please, come back tomorrow.
All right, in that case, we'll just wait in the room. You don't mind, do you? It's upstairs, right?
Wait, you can't.
Don't worry, we'll be discreet.
In the corridor. It's the first door on your left. I'll tell Dr. Gray you're here.
Excellent. Thank you, madam.
Commonplace book.
Every night the dark man stands on the threshold. Count the days until my spirit spills out my tired shape. Only his pallid mask shelters my remaining sanity. Staring directly in the face of that demonic sultan, surely sunder time itself.
How did you first come to understand such things, Signora? How did you know that the battered boiler in the basement would lead me to Lafayette Cemetery? Or how the old upstairs clock, with its astronomical motifs, would take me to that hateful mount outside of Claremont Harbor? Those are my memories, my past. Is there perhaps a chance, if ever so small, for me to see Tirola? Tirola? Whatever. I want them more than anything. Please let my talisman take me there. Let me sit with one under his Bodhi tree. Despite having sold me that talisman, Miss Jackson, the voodoo priestess, revealed none of her secrets to me. That's why I had to travel to Tonk. Instead, she cruelly told Baptiste, my caretaker, that he would be betrayed and killed in the most awful way. That the one he loved would pierce his thigh with a sharp spear, and that he would be devoured by his own mother. What a terrible thing to say. The Dark Man offered me a prison and I accepted. I signed the miscarried contract and entered the Dark Pact. Everyone is safe except for me. And that's the end of that. Okay, so I think we're going to get our very first puzzle very soon.
throw some of this stuff out? You're crazy too if I had this much junk lying around.
At least she could have done his weight. Now things are gonna start getting real. Investigate the corner store. Of no use here. What sort of items can I pick up? Can be thrown. The corner store. Johnny the Conqueror, Roots in Medicine. Interesting place for a corner store. Even more interesting name. That. bike. I thought I could ride it. Right, we can't go that way. Okay, we're gonna need a key, so I guess it's back to the corner store. You're not gonna get the jump on me that easy. I wish there was some sort of dodge. Yeah, go ahead and drink some booze. Nature's painkiller. Let's go find out what's going on in here. Preserved reptile. Ooh, lovely. Golden on horns. Useful items here. Oh god. I think that might have been an example of having to throw a consumable item to distract the enemy, as I think. Oof. Juju. So this is for the Crescent City. An old talisman shaped over centuries. The engraving of the numbers look to less than 100 years old, but the base could be from antiquity. A polished black sunstone in the middle has a glass finish and occasionally gives the impression of hiding picture within itself. Huh. Interesting. For the talisman. Now things are getting more interesting.
I was wondering when you were going to show up. Mrs. Thompson told me. I understand you are working for Jeremy Hardwood's niece.
Yeah, I guess so. I mean, I'm not wrong. I came here for her uncle. I just didn't expect this. You are Dr. Gray.
That's right. You don't happen to have some identification, do you? I'm not keen on having strangers pry. Edward Conway, Decatur Street, New Orleans. Enjoying the Vieux Carré, Detective? Those old French quarters, the voodoo people, the gangsters. I'm sure you live an exciting life.
Well, it's not quite like the story, Doc. I'm just trying to make a living.
Aren't we all making a living? Well, welcome to DeSanto, Detective. I hope your time here will be useful. Now, what can I do?
Just tell me where I can find Jeremy Harper.
Why wouldn't that make for a short visit? I wish I could tell you, but I'm afraid I don't know. A drink, Detective?
Anything brandy.
Oh, you do belong in the French quarters, Detective. Armagnac or Cognac?
You know, just give me the cheap stuff. I'm not much of a consumer.
Having low standards is not a virtue, Detective. Let me see if I can broaden your perspective.
What can you tell me about Jeremy?
I wouldn't want to go into details about his condition. Doctor-patient confidentiality. I'm sure you understand.
Sure. HIPAA before HIPAA.
It's crazy. It's missing. Why?
But there are loopholes that prevent HIPAA from taking effect, and I think investigational work is one of them. Chapter 2.
Talk to Dr. Gray. We'll rendezvous later.
It's just a bell. Six. Staff and patient directory.
Dr. L. Morley Gray is DeCento's chief nut. Accounting and all administrative work is handled by me, always. Magdalena Thompson, Mags, is responsible for the household. Jean-Baptiste and Charlotte Tavois are responsible for keeping the guests' medical regimens in check. Finally, Jack Chance is our gardener, who can occasionally be seen in the conservatory, but is for the most part busy outside. There are currently six guests in the center. Malcolm McCarthy and Ruth Talon reside on the first floor. Jeremy Hartwood, Elisabetta Perosi, Grace Saunders, and of course Cassandra Beauregard live on the second floor.
Oh, looks like we're just starting to, seems like some of the stuff starting to, pieces are, or seems like some pieces of the puzzle are starting to come together. And we're not quite done finishing looking in here. Yeah, I don't have the combination for that. Rose Arch painting. The old classic case of I give you a piece of the Rose Arch painting and you tell me what's the first thing that comes to your mind. That's how they work. Uh-oh, looks like we're committing some HIPAA violations. But then again, like I said, considering I work in a medical field, there are loopholes, but like I said, I think investigation work might be one of them. Sandra Beauregard, 47, female, room number 8. Responsible party, Mr. Frank Chardot. Literary agent, address, Jackson Square, French Quarter. Reason for admission, Cassandra suffers from writer's block and needs to finish her moving picture script before the end of June. Mr. Chardot suggests Cassandra's heavy use of barbiturates is holding her back and risks ruining her career. Got an addict. Cassandra Beauregard is a beloved crime author who managed to pull herself out of poverty and into stardom. 5 years ago, she tried killing herself by jumping off a balcony. The incident left her a cripple and now relies heavily on her wheelchair. Cassandra suffers chronic back pain following her suicide attempt. She self-administers morphine to keep herself ambulant, but has become addicted and the desired effect is now lost. Yep. Yep. And I know, definitely do know for a fact that morphine is also used during labor deliveries as well. If I remember correctly, I think they inject it into the spine. Because when you're delivering a baby, it is going to be it is extremely painful. But anyways, the drug abuse clouds her mind, and she is unable to focus on real life. To save herself from the insight, she instead makes up stories to fill out the gaps in her own thought process, resembling the Korsakoff syndrome. And also, for the record, morphine's a C, too. Anyways, first of all, she needs to be weaned from her drug addiction and hope it will resolve her compulsive lying. With morphine, good luck. Then look into permanently numbing her pain in her back through surgery, finally dealing with her suicidal thoughts. Native admission, March 15th, 1930. Grace Saunders, age 11, sex female, room number 7. Mrs. Gabriella Saunders, mother, address, Orleans Avenue, City Park. Reason for admission, the mother insists on strict supervision by a proper gentleman to avoid further perversion of Grace's adolescence. Huh? Personal history. Grace's family possesses modest wealth and status. Her childhood seemed ordinary, spending most of her time with private teachers and family friends. Grace's father recently passed away, leaving her mother the sole caregiver. Bummer. Grace has trouble dealing with her father's death. She is willingly suppressing her feelings on the matter and isn't properly acknowledging the trauma she suffered. Grace needs nothing out of the ordinary. She simply needs parental guidance. Eventually, we can work on her feelings toward her father. December 16th, 1928. Malcolm McCaffrey, 54, male, number one. McCaffrey admitted himself to Dorsetto, stating simply that he needs some damn rest. McCaffrey claims he used to work as a lawyer in Baton Rouge, but says he can't go into details because of some legal dispute. His background remains largely a mystery, except for the occasional clue that he drops in conversation. McCaffrey is an anxious man and an alcoholic. He often tells half-truths due to some deep-seated inability to trust other people. There's more to it than that. McCaffrey will take some time to open up. Spending time with Jack's dog or the child should be good for him. Their harmless nature will help build his sense of trust. Elisabetta Perossi, 33, female, room number 6, Naples, Italy, family home. Perossi broke into DeCredo and was found wandering the grand parlor. She was confused and suffered partial amnesia. She insisted she belonged here and offered to pay for her stay. Anyways, personal history. Perossi claims to have been a member of the Astarte artist colony some 20 years ago. A claim that seems contrafactual due to her young age. She looks to be and even thinks she is 30 years of age. That would make her a child at the time. It seems fair to say that Perossi's story is untrue, deliberate so or not. Perossi's story is peculiar because she retracted her story about the artist colony. She no longer claims to be the same person as Elisabetta Perossi. However, my staff's research has confirmed there was a Perossi at the time who was in her early 30s. I wanted to contact the real Perossi, but it seems the whole colony disappeared one night, September 29th, 1915, during a hurricane. I will have to take it slow and figure out what this spell of impersonation could have been. November 21st, 1927. Finally, Ruth Talon, age 29, female, room number 2. Mr. Etienne Talon, father, Burgundy Street, French Quarter. Ruth's father wishes that his daughter is removed from New Orleans nightlife for the foreseeable future. He fears that her overly free spirit is tarnishing the family's reputation. Ruth comes from considerable wealth. Her family owns several hotels and restaurants. Unlike the rest of the family, her sense of adventure has taken her around the world, including France during the Great War as a photojournalist. The last decade, she has provoked many rumors of being a DuPont flapper, bordering on nymphomaniac. Despite her father's frivolous reasons for her to be admitted, Ruth does seem to provide an interesting case. She is refreshingly open and doesn't shy away from talking about her life during the war or her continuous celebration after returning back to the States. She's admittedly a sexual deviant and feels no remorse. Wow. Simply staying at DeCredo should do wonders for Ruth, if not at least for her family's reputation. Ruth doesn't need to change, but with therapy I might be able to share with her some sympathy towards her family. I doubt she will settle down and become as dull as the rest of them, but at least she might try to be more discreet in the future. July 1st, 1928. And Jeremy, I wonder what his story is all about. Anyways, let's go to room number 6. Find out what. Oh wait. Oh shoot! I just realized there's one more door I got to go through. Okay, so I guess I don't have the right key. Thought I did, but I guess I don't. Anyways, off to room 6. You can't zoom in either. Interesting. There's nothing in here. Let's just keep moving on. So yeah, we are going to have to come back later. Yeah, we already know about all this here. So I guess now... So I think now the only thing we have to do is... Go to Lottie's room? Oh, you're going to the library. Here we go. You know what? Wait. Oh, right. All right, we need the medicine cabinet key. So I think as far as the wine cellar goes, there's a clue mentioning the wine cellar. All right. Okay, looks like I am getting a little ahead of myself. Because I think I have to go to room number... So it looks like I don't have a choice but to go to room number 6. Fine. I can do that. First, I gotta go check out the library. Let's see if anything of use is in here. Lost Plantations of Louisiana.
Plantations of Louisiana. Taylor Baker, 1917. Yes, that was a small plantation on the eastern shore of Lake Pontchartrain. The land was squeezed out to the cut from the stream and was sold for only $30 to Eliah Bigfoot in 1918. Bigfoot employed hundreds of workers from nearby villages to clear the woods and build a small plantation which, basically, is a striking blue fire. Kept in
Interesting. Anything else of use in here? Let's take a look at the parlor. Something was there. Oh, fireplace kit. Huh. That's weird. Why would it highlight and not be interacted with? Anyways, let's see this. Oh! Is this the witch from the other side? Okay, so I'm gonna need something else to, unpry that. Well, wish me luck. What the? Hello? What in the world? What do we have here? Debris. Get off of me, you little. Get off. Get off! Uh-oh. Is there a way out of here? Aha! Bolt cutters. Perfect. Just what I was looking for. Back to the drawing room. That was very bizarre. Okay. Anything else in this room before? Oh yeah, that's the wedge. But I think we're gonna have to come back later to unpry that. Oh, so we're back here again. I wonder. The map is of no use here. What? So let me get this straight. The map was useful back in the other room, and now it's saying it's useless here? Where's the logic in that? I'm beginning to wonder if I can, shortcut. Very nice. Time to go see what's inside the tool shed. Oh. Just a hatchet and water hose. And there's something I'm mentioning of a well. Let's see if I can follow the hose. That's where it'll take me. Not very far. Oh, here we go. Where are you taking me? Ah. Okay, here it is. Uh-oh. Alright, is this the plate? Alright, so I got that. Oh, I gotta go back to the boiler room. And there's more items in this place? Oh. What do we have here? A mummified cat. Oh, that's lovely! Oh, jeez. Alright, that takes care of that. So now I can go ahead and, loop de loop. If you. Well, actually, I should take a bit of a shortcut now that I got the ladder up. Oh, I get it. You can only carry one at a time. There we go.
You know, Mr. Woods, I saw a piece of the plate with Liza broke. I think she's been hiding them. She's not very good at it. She just chucked it into the little room with all the tools behind the boiler. I left it there. I didn't want to embarrass her by picking it up while she was looking. We went upstairs instead and played back. I let her win. She's so unhappy. Looked like the one on display in Cassandra's room. You know about that one already, right? Or is your eyesight really that fuzzy? I hope you don't feel bad about your glasses. You only look stupid when you squint. Maybe if you had more eyes, you would see these things. I wish you had all the eyes you need. Your best and favorite guest, Grace.
No? Okay, so I guess this is not it. Nope. Okay, so I guess this isn't it. It looks like this goes elsewhere. Okay, so I guess, so I wonder if I really do have to go back upstairs. Because like I said, I think I am getting a little ahead of myself. Like I said, I am getting some Resident Evil vibes from this. Or maybe I'm just overthinking things. I don't know. There's not much else I can do here. for Dr. Gray. Okay, so I guess that's off limits for now. Like I said, now my next stop is room number 6. I thought it'd be close by, but once again, more wishful thinking. Myself lost. Oh, that's right, I gotta go through the piazza. That's right. I think that's the way back. Yeah, I think I need to be here. Looks like we're missing a piece. All right, but we're on the right path.
Sorry, Detective.
Didn't mean to obstruct justice. It's fine. You know, I'm kind of missing a long case with this person. I was wondering if you've seen Grace go about AI.
Can't say that I have. Why are you asking?
Looking for her.
Is she in trouble?
No. She's just hiding somewhere. Can't have a rascal like that running around. Check.
And I'm sure you will be.
I'll keep an eye out for your man, Jeremy. You scratch my back, I'll scratch yours.
More like, scratch my back and I'll stab yours. Anyways, you know what, before I go in here, I gotta go in here first. I just realized I didn't, okay, never mind, that's a locked door. So now back to here. Emily is here. I think I can get the shotgun with him. So, this room's all finished. Here it is. Well, 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 what do we have here? Complete the shape with the rot in the paintings. Okay. Perosi's journal. So I wonder if the... Wait. I just noticed something. So I wonder if the green indicates that I have what I need to solve the puzzle in the current room. So, Scorpio, Sagittarius, and Aquarius, huh? Hang on a second. So I need the M, the plus arrow, and the waves. Wait a second. Wait a minute. Look at this again. And yes, I know it goes clockwise, but... There's gotta be more clues in here somewhere. Yeah. This green indicates that I have what I need. But I gotta put it all together. I don't need the flashlight on here. So I can only assume that Capricorn is 12, and then Pisces through Virgo are Pisces through Libra are 2 through 9, respectively. But what's the number combination? There's gotta be more this in here somewhere. Wait. William Argus, Franklin Mosig, Nora Keith. Wait. So Nora Keith is 4. Franklin Mosig is 9. William Argus is 2. So it's 2, 9, 4. Alright, let's put those together. So in this case, it would be Pisces, Libra, and Taurus. Pisces, Libra, Taurus. Bingo. There it is, the other piece of the broken plate. Perfect. Alright, that wasn't too difficult to figure out. Well, for the most part, I'm not going to get overconfident about it. What the? Whoa. Now things are starting to get more interesting here. Get off. The Valley of Snakes. That was weird. Ugh, no matter how many times I look at that thing creeps me out. Ugh. It's like... Ugh. Okay, I know for a fact that this has to go here. This could go here. First time. There we go. Bingo. Oh. this. A commonplace book, huh? Yeah, let's look into that. So there's a little bit of a triangle in the center. I know these five pieces are right. It's the last three that are, Let's take a look at the comic book again. It's on the last page too. Unless these got mixed up. No. No, I was actually right. Yeah, this... Yeah, this is right. I'm just still trying to figure out exactly, these last four corners in. Yeah. There's an extra crack here somewhere. That's the only thing I think of, maybe. No, this... No, these have to be correct. No, these are right. Because I can't imagine the corner being... It would seem kind of ridiculous to have, the corner being incorrect, because then I'd be like, what? Because, here's the thing, if I were to go back to the comic book... Yeah, if you look right there, everything connects. And yet, it's not solved. Huh. Everything else was pretty easy up until this point. There's gotta be something wrong with this. Because these are the only three pieces I have left, and yet... And yet... All these pieces just look so identical. There's gotta be something screwed up here. Because if that was. Because if. No matter what. No, because I don't know, like I said, this is right, this is right. What am I missing? What the heck am I missing here? It's weird you can't zoom in, because that would be nice. I'm under the assumption that something's missing. What? No, what the? No, this is right. This is right. This is right, because that's how they all connect. Unless there's more to this. I mean, heck if I know. I'm gonna look at this again. Boy, this is taking a lot longer than expected. Yeah, like I said, it's stupid you can't zoom in. There's got to be more to this. There just has to be. The clock ticking is getting really annoying. This was right. And I've tried every single combination up to this point, and even I'm starting to get a little annoyed over the fact that, because something like this should not be that difficult to figure out. I might have to look this up here, which is something I really don't want to do, but I'm burning time here. astronomical clock. Which I already found. So, right. Something is very off about all this. Man, even I'm still scratching my head about all this. Okay, I've got all the pieces here, but... Almost edges? Yeah, like I said, it's too bad you can't zoom in. That's the problem. You see, it just spirals. That's just it. It spirals. I didn't really want to do this, but... this is so annoying. Yeah, I was actually on the right path before, but... But it's these last three pieces here that are driving me nuts. God, that was more annoying than it really needed to be. Oh, this is a layered puzzle now. What room would that be, may I ask? Uh-oh.
As his pride failed, Detective Conley was left with a feeling of loneliness. He had successfully managed to enter a whole new world. How could this be? And why did he accept this so? There were no answers to be found by standing around questioning reality, knowing only what he read in the comic books. Conley headed off to look for Jeremy in the hateful mountain.
So what we got going on in here? Oil report.
About his presence. I promise not to return to the compound. Instead, he has taken.
so I don't have the key. Jetty key. Okay. Nothing of interest here. Excuse me. Alright, now the door's unlocked. Perfect. Back to that jetty. Here. Lever. Keep this stream going for a little while longer, because we're making good progress here. Actually, you know what? I think this is a good place to stop for right now. I mean, like I said, I made some good progress. Only got stuck once. Like I said, it was a solid experience here, I gotta admit. But anyways, that's it for the session here. Thank you to those who watched. I'll see you all next time.